Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today's video is about the ordinary products, when to use, how to use. So let's dive right in, shall we? So you got your big box from DECIEM. You have all the nice packaging inside and now you're like, yeah, well, I ordered this, but where do I use it and how? And that's what I will be telling you today. As in my last video, I have my laptop down below with all my notes. There are a lot of notes, so I will be looking down. This video will be longer than my last video, but it does build on it. So if you haven't seen that one, go check it out, because there I tell you how to pick the best products for your problems and how to find the best routine for you. So this one goes from you got your products home, how and when do you use those? So let's get started. First, I want to tell you what is a layer or a skin, because you hear a lot of layering your skin care. The 7 skin method, all that kind of thing. So what is a layer? A layer is just a layer of product you put on your skin. That's also why it's called a skin. One skin is the same as a layer. And if you put one serum on top, that's one layer. And if you have a hydrating toner, if you apply it more than once, then every time you apply the toner is one layer. So we have that out of the way. What is most important to remember? You need to remember when to use what. Not product-wise, but consistency-wise. So you start with water, then oil and oily feelings. I place those under oils. Then go your creams, then come your silicones. The other thing is you go from thinnest to thickest consistency. It's easier for your skin to absorb it that way. Water-based serums from The Ordinary are a little bit more gel-like, not a thick gel, but a little bit more. They have a more body to them, so they go after your very runny, thin products. For the oils, the squalane is, I think, the thinnest oil that they have. So if you are layering oils, you could start with the squalane and then put your other oils on top. Most products from The Ordinary can be used morning and night, but there are a few exceptions, and the exceptions are the retinoids and retinols. They only go at night. Most acids only go at night. The exception to those are the azelaic acid and the salicylic acid. Those two you can use morning and night. The peel, the AHA, BHA peel, only use at night. For me personally, high percentages of vitamin C, so the 23 and the 30%, I like to use those at night. I know a lot of people use them during the day as well, but when I use the 30%, I used it only at night because I want to get the maximum benefit of the vitamin C without the vitamin C having to fight all the free radicals. So it's up to you. My personal preference is to use the high percentages at night only. There are some oils that you can only use at night. The sea buckthorn oil is a new oil from The Ordinary, and that one is only to be used at night. And DECIEM also advises to use the rosehip oil only at night. You can use it during the day, the rosehip oil. I didn't have any problems, but you know, if you are just starting out and this is your very first routine you are trying to build for The Ordinary, just use it at night. And you know, when you get a little bit more comfortable with the products and with layering many more products than you are used to on your skin, you can experiment a little bit and you can shift some things around. But just for now, the real basic is stick to what I'm telling you and build from there once you get used to the products. Also, if you have any questions or comments or tips for me, leave them down in the comment section below and I will get back to you as soon as I can. going back to my notes again. Let me see. Yeah, morning and night. It's also on the outer packaging. I will get one for you. This is one from Marine Hyaluronics. And this is what the packaging looks like. Then you have the side, and I don't know if it's backwards. If it is, I'm sorry. But if you look a little bit closer, here you have the directions. Here you have what it's doing. Directions: apply a few drops to face AM and PM before creams, and it also says fragrance free. The whole line from The Ordinary is fragrance free. I think it's also gluten free and it's all cruelty free, so that's really good. But what if you, in your enthusiasm, threw the packaging out already, or you ordered some products before, want to incorporate them now, and you don't have the packaging anymore? Yeah, it can happen. You can do some things. You can check the Deciem website, their regimen guide. I will link it down below. If you click on the regimen guide, the first thing you see are the types of products. The retinoids is, I believe, the first one you see. You click the little plus behind it. It drops down, and there you can see the name of the product and if you can use it during the day or at night. That's what it says on the website. If you don't want to look it up, just follow the rules that I gave you before. Water before oil, then come your creams, then your silicon based, and you go from thinnest to thickest consistency. If you remember, acids go only at night, retinoids only go at night, then you're actually good to go, because, oh, and maybe high percentages of vitamin C. So how to build your routine: get a pen, get a piece of paper, and make a column and write down this AM and PM. Then you get your product, the product that you you got maybe four products, I don't know. So you get your product. This is a buffet, and it doesn't matter. Okay, here I have an outer packaging. It says on the outer packaging that I can use this one AM and PM. So what I do is I write the product name in both columns, like so, because I can use this morning and night. And you do that with all the products. What do you do if you don't have the outer packaging anymore? You just follow the rules that I talked about earlier. So here I have the buffet. Okay, so it's in a clear bottle. That means it's a water-based serum. It's not an acid, so it can go morning and night. Buffet. Buffet. Okay, what if this says salicylic acid? It's a clear bottle, so it's water-based, but there is acid in the name. So salicylic acid, we qualify underneath the acids, that one goes at night. So you write in your PM column salicylic acid. What do you have? What if you have hyaluronic acid? That also is in a clear bottle and it has acid in the name. Now what? Where do you place that? Hyaluronic acid is the exception to the rule. Yes, it has acid in the name, but it is not an exfoliating acid and it also does not clean out your pores. Hyaluronic acid attracts moisture to your skin. So that one can go morning and night. So I'm just going to write down some thingies and okay. So you have something like this. Yeah, you listed all your products here. You know what you can use morning, what you can use at night. What you can do now is take another piece of paper and just go and write down your routine. So you would get something like this, but you have your AM and you have your PM. As I mentioned, water-based goes first. So you have the hyaluronic acid, that one goes first. You also have a buffet, that one can go after. And you have an oil. So you would write down something like this: AM, your HA, then your buffet, and then your oil, and then you can go from there. Same you can do at night, and that way you can really see how to do something. This is one of mine. This is an old one of mine. And as you can see, I have more than one AM and I have more than one PM routine. Saturday is my peel day, so that one goes first. And then I have a product that I can only use maximum 3 times a week. So that one goes somewhere, and then the other, I just split it up because I found it easier to get used to this routine that I have going on right now. As I said, this one is old because I have another one as well, but I'm quite used to the products now, so I don't need that one anymore. What I do want to mention is I mentioned the word acid now a few times already, and when I am talking about acids, I am talking about AHAs and BHAs. What are AHAs for those of you who don't know it? AHAs are they are water soluble, and the AHA is to get rid of the dead skin cells, and the BHA is oil soluble and goes into the pores and cleans them out. So they have glycolic, they have lactic 5%, they have lactic 10%, and they have mandelic 10%. Those are the AHAs. The glycolic is in a big bottle, and it's actually more used as an acidic toner. The lactic acid is more of a serum, but it's really runny, and the mandelic is oil based. So how to use those? As I said before, only use your acids at night, especially if you are not used to them. And how do you use it? You apply everything on a clean, clean, dry skin, and do not mix your acids. Because the glycolic and the lactic acid are really thin, they go right after cleansing. So that's the first step in your routine. Just wait until they are dry and go on with the rest of your routine. For the mandelic acid, it is a little bit different because it's oil based. So you use that one as the first oily product that you use after your water based serums. If you don't have any water based serums, it just goes right after cleansing. The salicylic acid is also a bit of a different class. It's not watery, it's a bit thicker. And it's used as a spot treatment, so it's not supposed to go over your entire face. If you have the salicylic acid because you have acne, or you have blackheads or big pores, or you want to clean out your pores, usually it's acne can be all over your face, I know. But just use it there when you need it, where you need it. Do not put it right here. If you have acne here, just be careful, and maybe you can get a cotton bud, do a little drop on a cotton bud so you can really precisely spot treat those areas around your eyes and more sensitive areas of your skin. Just remember that salicylic acid can dry out your skin. So if you have dry skin already, you could use it with a few layers in between. You can also use it after your moisturizer if you want to. You can also use it first. Of course you can use it first, but just check how your skin reacts, and if it dries, it really dries out in those areas, move it up a bit in your routine so you still have it before your oils, but you have a few layers of other water-based products in between. So what else do I want to say? Yeah, again, as I mentioned before, if you are not used to acids, do not mix them in the same routine. So for instance, you have lactic acid and you have salicylic acid. As I said before, acids go at night, but you have two. Now what do you do? Well, you move your lactic acid you use at night on a dry face right after cleansing. Your salicylic acid you move to your daytime routine and use it as a spot treatment. Before I forget, if you want to use the salicylic acid at night and you also have another acid, as I said, do not use them in the same routine, but alternate nights. That includes mandelic acid. So if you have salicylic acid, which is a water-based product, and you have mandelic acid, which is oil-based, Yes, they are in two different steps in your routine, but they are both acids, and it can just be too much for your skin, especially if you are just starting out with acids. So do them on alternating nights. So for instance, Monday you do your salicylic acid and the next day you do your other acid and vice versa. The peel is the most potent product that they have. It's a 30% AHA, 2% BHA. And if you are not used to acids, do not use it yet. Put it aside. Don't use it if you are just starting out, because it's just powerhouse. If you do have it and you really want to use it because you ordered it, because you saw that it was listed in your regime, fine, just be careful. So pick a day. My peel day is on a Saturday. What do you do then? You clean your face, make sure it's really clean, then pat it dry. It needs to be dry. If you put the peel on top of a damp skin, you're going to feel it because it stinks like, you know. Then you put it on your face. Do not put it close around your eyes or your mouth. You don't want to do that. Put on a thin layer and leave it for a few minutes the first time. It says on the bottle maximum of 10 minutes and use one or two times a week. I know what it says on the bottle because I have it, but my advice is start slow. If you over exfoliate, it takes a long time to get your face back to where you need it to be. So start really slow. So the first time use it maybe 2 or 3 minutes, you know. You apply it, you wait a little bit, maybe you go to the bathroom or something like that, or you brush your teeth and then just rinse it off. Rinse it, make sure you have everything off, pat your face dry, and then just use hydrating products over it. A nice oil. Don't use vitamin C's. If you are not used to it, this again, don't use any vitamin C's, don't use any retinoids, and don't use any other acidic product. You can use your hyaluronic acid, that's actually great, and then really pack it in with moisture to give your face the most hydration it can get. Then just go over it with a nice oil or the natural moisturizing factors or your own moisturizer, and that is it. So that was the peel, and it was really important for me to talk about the peel. What else is really important and what I really want to get across is start slow, especially with acids, high percentages of vitamin C, and the retinoids and retinols. If you are not used to, are they bad for your skin? No, definitely not. They're not bad for your skin, but your skin can react. You know, if your skin is not used to those products, and it's like, if you want to run a marathon, you're not just going out your door and run 42 kilometers without training first. You understand what I'm saying? So start slow. Personally, this is a bit of a controversy, but what do I believe? And it's my video. I believe, in my experience, that most of the water-based serums can be used instantaneously, so you get them and you can use them. I know there are some people that are having problems with niacinamide. I did not. My skin really liked it, but what did I do? I started mixing fairly soon. And what do I mean by that? Instead of using 3 drops for your face of one particular product, I used just 1 drop of product. And I mixed it in with a product that I was already using. So that's how I start. And what you can also do is water-based products, and I'm not talking acids now, except hyaluronic acids, the HA. You can all mix them with moisture, either with water or with a hydrating toner, one that does not contain alcohol and soapy stuff. You can mix it. So what can you do? You get a new product, you just put a little bit of hydrating toner or just a little bit of water on the palm of your hand, 1 drop of product in, mix it around a bit, go like this, spread it all over your face. That way you dilute it a bit, but you can still use it morning and night when you get the products home. And that's actually how I started. I started with HA and B5, Buffet, the Granactive Retinoid 2% Emulsion, and the Squalane Oil. And what did I start to use right away was the Buffet, the HA, and the Rosehip Seed Oil. The Squalane, because Rosehip was sold out. So those three products I used the next, I got the products that evening. I used those products for the first time and the next day as well. The only thing that I started really slow with from the products that I got was the retinoid, because my skin had never had a retinoid. So I started slow. I started with once a week on a Saturday, didn't have any problems. I really checked my skin. I didn't have any irritation, no flakiness, no extra dry spots. I waited a few days and then I used it again on Wednesday and then Saturday again, and no problems. And the next day I used it three times a week, no problems. And then I just used it every day and I haven't had any problems with it. So that's just my two cents. So again, I think that you can use the water-based products, except the salicylic acid and the other AHAs, right away. And again, what you can do is just put one drop on the palm of your hand, little bit of moisture, go like this, and then spread it all over your face. That way your skin can get used to the product as well, and the risk of irritation is minimum. You can always have irritation. Every new type of product that you use, you can have irritation. You can get irritation from stuff that you are using, well, 20 years or something. It can always happen. If you are using to use only one or two products at a time, the benefit of that is that if you do get a reaction, you can really easily see which product causes the problem. So it's just up to you. Just be careful to, again, what I said, be careful with the acids, the high vitamin C's and the retinoids. Just start slow, just once a week, and then build up from that. You can again also dilute it, so the water-based products can be diluted with other water-based products, except the acids. Your retinoid, if you have the Granactive Retinoid Emulsion, the water-based one, you can also dilute that with hydrating toner. If you have the retinoids that are squalane-based, you can dilute it with your oil, or you can also dilute it with your moisturizer. So, and the same goes with vitamin C's, the high vitamin C's. Dilute them first. And just remember that the skin here is more sensitive than the skin on your face. So just, you know, use your common sense. That's what I'm trying to say. And I know it's really tempting to use everything at once, the really thick layers. That's what I like to do first as well. But then you get you can get irritation easier, you get peeling and all that kind of things. So again, let's recap the basic stuff for now. Water before oil. So you have your clear bottle, you have your dark bottle, you have your creams, your silicones, and your acids come on a dry skin right after cleansing. Hyaluronic acid is not an acid. Start slow with acids, and also do not mix acids, and I mean the exfoliating acids, so the AHAs, the BHAs. Go slow with the high vitamin C's and with the retinoids. And if you are new to acids, I recommend not using the peel right away, but if you really want to use it, pick one evening and just leave it on for just a few minutes. This part concludes the basic stuff. The next part, and it's still the same video, but what I am going to talk about next is, you have your routine and now you want to incorporate some extra products. How do you do that? So that's what I'm going to talk about next. So if you want to skip that part and go straight to the tips and tricks that I will be giving at the end of the video, you can just hit the timestamp listed down below. So what if you got a little carried away and you got more products than were in your routine, listed in the routine from the previous video, or you have some products that maybe you got as a gift, or you got somewhere and you don't know how to incorporate that, or you want to just add new products into your routine. This is not about ingredients, but I will touch up on what you can and cannot use together in the same routine. So basically the same rules apply as I mentioned in the first part of this video. If you have skipped ahead, I will briefly list it. As you may already know, if not, well, then you know now. The rule is water before oil, then come your cream, then come your silicones. If you are a little bit more familiar with The Ordinary, you know that the water-based serums are in the clear bottles. The oils are in the dark bottles, except the Granactive Retinoid Solution and the Ascorbyl Glucoside Solution, the vitamin C derivatives. Those two are water-based but are in dark bottles. And then you have the tubes that contain your creams. I also mentioned in the previous piece where to use acids. You can skip back a bit. I have a timestamp for the acids, so you can hit that timestamp and then just watch from there. So I don't have to repeat myself and make the video even longer. What can you not use together? You can use most things together. The exception, one of the exceptions is the AUK. And AUK134 is an antioxidant. It's a really exciting product actually, because it can regenerate itself and can boost other antioxidants. But it's a bit complicated. It's a complicated product because it's a bit sensitive. Yes. This is what the Deciem website says. AUK134 must not be used immediately with strong acids, such as suspensions of ascorbic acid. Strong acids will completely destroy AUK134, which is based on manganese. And then they have a little part below that, because you have another antioxidant that's resveratrol and ferulic acid. And though there is a little bit of conflict between resveratrol and the AUK as well, and this is what Deciem says, if you wish to take advantage of both the resveratrol plus ferulic acid and the AUK, either use them at different times or apply each in a separate step, since acids and AUK134 should not be mixed together. Well, what does that mean? And what if you have glycolic acid or lactic acid or mandelic acid or salicylic acid? How I interpret this part, and I really thought about it, and this is what I make of it. As long as there are a few layers between your acidic product, so your AHA, BHA, your ascorbic acid product, and AUK, then you can use them in the same routine. Just make sure that they are products between them. The easiest thing sometimes to do is just move AUK to either your morning routine or your evening routine. Personally, I would not use two silicone-based products in the same routine. And with the same routine, I mean morning or night. So not a day routine, but a morning or a night routine. That's just my personal preference. If I had, for instance, the azelaic acid, which is silicone-based, and the vitamin C 30%, which is silicone-based, I would use the azelaic acid in the morning and the vitamin C at night. Maybe I would even mix them together. So you could try that. I know the magnesium ascorbic, I will list the name in the above here, We mostly call it MAP or MAP because that's just easier, but I will list the full name on the screen. That one is also silicon based. And I know there are routines that say use MAP during the day and azelaic acid at night, and that's fine. If you are used to both products, you can also try to mix them together because they both go after your creams. So just see how you like that. You also hear a lot about niacinamide and vitamin C. Deciem advises against the use of both together, but you know, the short answer is you can. I will not go into it here. I will link a blog post down below. It's by Kind of Steve, and he is a cosmetic chemist and he explains it really well. If you really do not want to use both together, you don't have to, but you can. And I really hope that the myth is busted now, because again, you can use niacinamide and vitamin C in the same routine. I talked about the peel earlier. If you have the peel and you are used to acids, I will touch on this one briefly again. If you have the AHA, BHA peel and you are used to acids, you can use it for the full 10 minutes. Even though you are used to acids, start with once a week and on a clean, dry skin. If it's not on a dry skin, it will burn like a, you know? And afterwards, just use hydrating products, a nice oil, your moisturizer. Do not use high vitamin C's. Actually, I wouldn't use vitamin C's at all. I just use my hydrating products. So that's a little tip, but just you do what you want to do. Just really listen to your skin. It's a very good product. But you can, you know, if you use it too often, you can damage your skin. So just be careful with it. It's not that it's dangerous, because it's not. It's just, you know, use your head, use your common sense and don't go overboard. Again, you may have heard this already. If you are a member of our Facebook group, or not our Facebook group, but the Facebook group that I am a part of as well, I will list it down below. You may have heard this again, start slow, start slow, start slow, start slow. If you are watching this piece, this part, I am going to assume that you are familiar with at least a basic routine from The Ordinary, and that you have used it more longer than a week or two. If you have not, don't add. Just stick to your basics, stick to your basic routine. Make sure that you are using everything from your basic routine before you start to add any other products. Tip, before I forget this, have reasonable expectations. What do I mean by that? The products from The Ordinary, at least the ones I use, they work. But they do not work overnight. You know, it's not a little magic wand in a bottle. It takes time. And a lot of times I see, someone says, well, I am using The Ordinary products and I don't see any difference. And then when they have to answer the question, well, how long are you using them for? 2 weeks. And then I'm like, it doesn't work that fast. It just doesn't. If it does for you, if you see immediate results, good for you. But I know, and that also can be a bit frustrating. One of the products, the alpha lipoic acid, is said to, a lot of people say that if you use it, then the next morning your face is all glowy and nice and has a healthy glow. And I don't know what they mean with healthy glow. If I use it, I don't see a difference in the morning. And I was like, am I doing something wrong then, maybe? But no, it's just, for me, the product, I also don't use 3 drops, I use 1, so maybe that is it. And I mix it with another oil, so maybe that is it as well. But you know, I don't have that glow, I think. But maybe I don't know what a healthy glow looks like. I don't know. Anywho, have reasonable expectations. Now we are getting to the tips. Sure. I will put a timestamp in again for the tips. So if you use the timestamp, here are my tips. most products can be mixed. First off, what you do not mix are the acids, the AHAs and the BHAs. You do not mix. Okay, yeah, fine. The rest you can. Most of them, anyway. You can mix water-based serums. So, for instance, I have here an empty bottle of Buffet and an empty bottle of niacinamide. What do? I screw them both open. I do depends. Maybe 2 drops of niacinamide in my hand, 2 drops of Buffet in my hand. I swirl a bit with my finger. I go like this, and I smear it all over my face. And why do I use 4 drops total? Because I also bring it down the back of my neck and the top of my hand, because that's skin as well. And I also do it on the back of my hands. You can also mix the oils together and the oily feelings together. The only thing that I would keep separate is the AUK. So you are just make sure that you, as I said before, that you are not mixing it with anything it doesn't want to play with, because it wants to be alone. So just use the AUK alone, because it likes it that way. But the rest can be mixed together as well. And, you know, it saves time. You can also mix in oils into the natural moisturizing factor or your own creams. Your own moisturizer. You can also mix silicone-based into your moisturizer to dilute the silicon base. That's what I did when I started using the vitamin C 30%. It was so high for my skin. My skin was not used to it, that I really diluted it down with natural moisturizing factors first to get my skin to get used to it. And then one night I didn't, and I brought it down on my neck and I got irritation. So just be careful, you know, just listen to your skin. Again, I didn't use my head. I don't know where I was with my brain that day, but it was not with what I was doing. So even if you are used to products like this, you can still make a boo-boo, and yeah, you know, you have to fix it. What I like to do as well is I use everything except my AHAs on a damp skin. I use a hydrating toner, then my water-based serums, then I pat hydrating toner on top of that again, and then I go in with my oil. I read somewhere that if you use oils on a damp skin, it helps the oil to absorb faster, and it also locks in the extra moisture. Now, I was already doing that for my water-based serum, so I thought, you know what, I'm going to try that. It really works for me. It also helps to stop the pilling. The product that pilled the most for me was my Granactive Retinoid, especially when I used oils on top of that. It would just pill like crazy. But if I use a hydrating, a wet layer in between, a moisture layer in between, it doesn't pill on me. So that's also a tip against pilling. Number one, don't use too much of the product, and apply on a damp skin. That you can also apply moisturizing creams on top of dry skin to help lock in some extra moisture. And what I also want to mention is my tried and true tip for making the hyaluronic acid plus B5 work for you. It is you either love it or you hate it product. If you live in a really dry climate, you can have a lot of problems with it, because if there is not enough moisture in the atmosphere around you, so to say, so it's not humid, it cannot get the moisture it needs out of the air, and it attracts it from inside your skin out. So you may see that your skin looks plump, but you can feel that it's dry inside your skin, if you know what I mean. We had that when I started with the hyaluronic acid. We had a really cold spell here in the Netherlands, and the weather was really, really dry because it was freezing. And my skin got more dehydrated, and I was like, okay, I have to pack it with moisture. I didn't have my hydrating toner at the time. What do I do? I also used water, just tap water, because that's what I had, and I patted that in. But what I found worked the best for me at that time was when I was in the shower. When you are in the shower and you turn off your faucet, you have all that steam and that moisture that is hanging around in your bathroom. Make advantage of that one. That's what I did. So I would shower, turn off the shower, turn off the water, and then pat my face dry just a little so it wasn't soaking wet. And then I applied my HA all over my face and on my neck and décolleté. And then I would just let it sit. Maybe I would pat it in a bit with my fingertips to pat in some extra moisture that it was attracting out of the air. And then I would just, you know, towel off, dry my hair, put on my body lotion. And all the while, the HA could soak up all the moisture that was in the air. So it could really do and just hold it in my skin. And then when I would come downstairs, I would go in with some extra moisture. I had a kind of a hydrating spray back then that I found. And I would use that over it. And then I would put my the rest of my skincare on top. Do I have any more? I don't think so. Let me check my notes again. Oh yeah, the most important tip, I almost forgot. Wear sunscreen. You have heard me say it before and I will keep saying it. Wear sunscreen. If you are stepping up your skincare game, sunscreen is the first thing that you should be using. What type of sunscreen? One you like. That's it. That was it. That was actually all I wanted to say. If I have forgotten anything, I will leave it in the comment section. If you guys have any questions or comments or just have your own tips that you would like to share with us, also leave that in the comment section down below. Hit the subscribe button. Don't forget the little bell, because YouTube is really doing weird things right now. And if you don't hit the bell but you are subscribed to my channel, it can be that you don't know when I upload, because YouTube thinks that you don't want to see my videos or something. I don't know what they're doing. So hit the button, hit the bell, give the video a thumbs up, and I will see you in my next one. Bye guys.